The first thing you might notice about the display editor is that the top bar from the home page is still available, which means you still have access to the home button, the new display button, and can refer to your authenticated account and any messages raised by PyVision. Just below the top bar, we have another set of functions. To the far left, we have our display title. Since we haven't saved out our new display yet, we can't edit this. Instead, it just reads, "Click Save Icon." But typically, we can use this to rename our display from within the editor. To the far right, we have our Save button. When we've made a change to our display, this button becomes active and we can save the edits that we've made. Using the drop-down to the right of the floppy disk, we also have the option to save as a new file or display, or export data on the display to a CSV or XML format. Below this, we have our toolbar. The toolbar consists of primarily editing and formatting functions, as well as static elements such as text boxes and geometric shapes. Let's add something to our display. We'll create a text box by clicking on the capital T, and then clicking again inside the display window. A few things just happened here. First and foremost, text popped up on our display. A panel also appeared on the right side of the window, which we'll call the Configuration Pane, and where we can control what text is shown, as well as a few styling options. Notice also that a new icon depicting a ruler and a pencil appeared to the left of our Save button. This button toggles between Modify Mode and Monitor Mode. Items on the display will respond differently to button clicks, depending on which mode is currently active. In Modify Mode, the icon will have an orange background, and you will also find an orange border around the entire display window. Other options on the toolbar include Undo, Redo, Cut, Copy, Paste, and Delete, which may also be invoked using standard keyboard shortcuts. This is also where you'll find the arrangement functions. To the left of the display viewport, we have the Assets Pane, Events Pane, and Graphics Library. The three may be cycled between using the three vertically aligned icons on the far left. Clicking on an option when it has already been selected will collapse the entire panel. The Assets Pane is where a bulk of our display content will come from. At the top of the panel, we have our data symbol list in order: trend, value, table, vertical gauge, horizontal gauge, radial gauge, XY plot, and asset comparison table. PyVision also supports extensibility, which means you can write your own symbols using JavaScript and HTML if you feel motivated to do so. Below the symbol list is a search box that we can use to find specific assets, attributes, and Py tags. Underneath that is our navigation structure. At the topmost level are our Py and AF databases. Asset framework databases have a hierarchical structure, which means they can be explored level by level, while Py data archives have a flat hierarchy and must be searched. Beneath the navigation structure is an attribute list. When we select an asset from the navigational structure, its attributes will populate the list below, which may then be used on the display. To build data symbols on the display, we want to first click on a symbol from the list to select it, and then find our data item, which will be a Py tag or attribute, and click and drag it onto the display. The Events pane taps into the power of event frames and their relation to our assets. By default, this pane will populate with events related to assets represented on the display that were active within the time range of the display. The built-in PyVision graphics library provides scalable vector graphics representing many process components and equipment to help you add more detail and context to your displays. Graphics may be added to your display either by dragging and dropping them from the library pane or by selecting them first and then drawing a placement rectangle on the display. Lastly, at the bottom of the display is the time bar. The time bar controls the time range of the display and therefore the data that's represented. To the bottom left and right, you can find the start and end times of the display, and both of these values may be replaced simply by entering your desired times into the boxes directly. The box in the center indicates the time coverage of the display and may be set to common intervals such as 1 hour, 1 day, etc. by clicking on it. The arrows to the left and the right of this indicator are used to jump forward or backward in time an amount equal to the duration of the display. The Now button may be used to jump to the current time, setting the display end time to star. When the Now button is green, the display's end time is current and will update in real time.